Okay, now you're going to show you know how to escape from the mount position, you know, using the technique called upa. Okay, just make sure you're starting from there. Just make sure then you keep your elbows blocking the guy's leg right here. So he cannot bring his knee under to RB right here. Okay, he cannot bring it. Once you block, you know, you have your elbow right there. It's not only for to block the knee, but then you guys are going to see later why, you know, you got to keep that. So the second thing you're going to see when Marcelo is going to start applying the choke in Junior's neck, like you can see right here. That's exactly when Junior is going to be holding his wrist over here. You see the full grip, like a shell hand, like full. And but don't grab right there. You can see right here. Don't grab the wrist and keep your elbow up. You gotta make sure then you keep the elbow down, pushing the knee, like you can see right there, pushing the knee. All right. So right away, the other hand is gonna still blocking his knee to make sure right here. Before you hold his elbow, then you're gonna be pushing his knee down so you can hook your leg right here. So you're gonna be holding the whole side. You see right here, the angle you guys can see, he's holding the whole side. He's holding the right side of Marcelo right here, the whole thing, the leg and the arm. So the next step, right, when you control the arm, hold one hand over here, the other one right behind his elbow, you're gonna be with the leg, you're gonna be lifting Marcelo forward. And I don't want you guys using your head, I want you guys using your shoulder to the same side. You're gonna turn Marcelo to the same side, the right side, go ahead. Pushing up. You see, right, Marcelo is losing the control. So he's, once again, make sure then you tie the whole side, the arm and the leg, the right arm and the leg. Make sure you have the hook right here. That's the reason you gotta push the leg down. So Junior is gonna lift Junior. Right, making Marcelo go forward. He's losing his balance, he's losing the contact, he's losing his base. Now, Junior is gonna bring Marcelo over his shoulder, right there, and Junior is gonna be in the side, inside the legs, inside the guard. Better than to be in the mount position. So you're here to teach you how to escape from the mount position, you know, when somebody mount on you, okay? Just make sure, then, once again, then you have your elbow, you know, pushing the guy's leg. Don't let the guy put his knee under your RB right there. Don't let him do that because you won't be able to escape from using the upa. So make sure that you block his knee with the elbow. The second step is going to be when Marcelo's trying to apply the choke in Junior's neck. That will be the time Junior's going to be holding his wrist right here. So you can see this way, you know, the way he's holding with the full grip right here. Five fingers holding together. And make sure that you don't lift your elbow, because if you lift your elbow, you're gonna be off in your arm for him to do another thing. So you wanna push the knee down, you're gonna put your elbow down, pushing the knee, so don't let he, you know, come up. The second hand is gonna come right to Marcelo's elbow. But make sure then also here, then you can keep your elbow pushing the other leg into, so you can block. Right here you can see. The way you see right here, you see he's blocking the whole side. He's blocking Marcelo's side. So that's exactly the side he's gonna escape. He's gonna roll Marcelo to the right side. So one, 3 points. Hold his wrist, hold his elbow, and make the hook with the leg. That's the main important thing right here. I don't want you also you guys go over your neck. I want you guys go over your shoulder so you don't hurt yourself. So now what Junior is going to do, he's going to lift Marcelo's ribs forward, so getting out of Marcelo, out of control, out of base over here. He doesn't have any base anymore, so he's out of balance. So Junior is going to roll over, you know, throwing Marcelo down and come to inside Marcelo's guard. That position should be much better for you to be inside the legs than to have somebody in the mount position. Okay, let's go, you know, to the main points now. You know, don't let the guy bring his knee up to the armpit. Right there, you block right away. So Marcelo is gonna come with attack. He's gonna attack Junior's neck, you give him the choke. Junior's gonna grab the wrist right there. The second hand is gonna go to Marcelo's elbow. Right there with the same side, he's gonna start pushing Marcelo's leg so he can hook the leg behind. So make sure, you know, you have the 3 points tight right there. So Junior's gonna roll Marcelo to the right side, lifting him up and go forward. Exactly, to be inside the legs. The better position than you be somebody more on you. So you're here to teach you how to give a good sweep from the when somebody tries to pass your guard, the basic one. So Marcelo is gonna, like you see, he's holding the junior's belt, and he's gonna be his left knee up. So the time, what a junior is gonna do, he's gonna accept that position, or he's gonna take something from there. What he's gonna open his leg, right away he's gonna lift a little bit, and he's gonna, at the same time he's lifting, you can guys see right here, he's lifting. So give him the ability to move, to show, you know, then he can cross his knee over the guy's belly right here. Once again, let me come back so make sure that you guys understand that point. So he's gonna, Marcelo brought his knee up, now he's gonna lift his ribs up, and now the knee is gonna come right crossing, you see right here, crossing Marcelo's belly right here. I don't want you guys come with the knee higher or lower. I want you guys look for the waist right here. And you can see, turn a little bit guys, you can see right here, the foot hooks right in the waist, like a little hook right here. Come back 1 second. So the same time the knee cross over Marcelo's belly, the other leg is gonna be blocking right here, the Marcelo's leg. The reason is because he wanna block the whole side. Like you, I think you guys already saw before, when you try to move things to one side, you gotta block the whole side. So now what a junior is gonna do, go ahead, you're gonna be holding the same side. You see, one hand is holding the wrist, the other hand goes to the neck, and now he's gonna play a kind of sweeping. He's gonna, the legs gonna, they go, the whole thing's gonna work like a scissor. He's gonna push the top of the body of Marcelo, and the bottom, he's gonna sweep the leg. He's gonna, like, cutting, and he's gonna move Marcelo down. Once again, to teach you, you know, the sweep called the scissor, the tesoura. You know, when Marcelo tries to pass the guard, you know, you see he's holding the bell, he's gonna bring his knee up, right there. So at that point, Junior, he's the one to fight, you know, to bring Marcelo, to make Marcelo put the knee down. He's gonna take advantage from there. What he's gonna do, he's gonna open the leg, when the calf, when he's gonna start lifting his body off. You see, he's lifting over here, to looking for a space to throw his knee right crossing Marcelo's belly, right here. You can see the belly is going inside, right? So the motion here is gonna be exactly like a scissor. But I make sure then you have the little hook over here. You see the little hook right there? So make a little safe for you. So the knee is gonna be right in the same level his waist, and also the other leg is gonna be right blocking the knee right here. So keep it holding. So now what a junior is gonna do, he's gonna release the arm over here, he's gonna go right to Marcelo's neck, so he's gonna be completely blocking the whole right side right here. So what he's gonna do, he's gonna just a little bit, pull him Marcelo a little bit so he can lose his balance, you know, totally. So now he's gonna switch the leg, go ahead, and sweep him to the get in a mount position. And also guys, I wanna give you guys the option, you know, like sometimes, you know, like you already know the whole position, you know, the knee crossing the belly, you know, the other leg blocking over here, he's holding the whole side. But sometimes what the guy do here, what he does is moving his leg inside. So he's gonna avoid Junior to push, you know, work exactly like a scissor, but he got an option for there. What I want you guys to pay attention, the exact when he moves the leg inside and he just leave over here, what Junior is gonna do, he's gonna start pushing, he's still right here, you can see right here, it's not anymore like a scissor, but he's gonna start pushing, and he still control the same size. Go ahead, pushing, and he's still gonna sweep him to looking for the mount position. So Marcelo is gonna start passing Junior's guard, he's gonna bring one knee up, Junior's gonna accept that situation, he's gonna turn his body, escaping, he's gonna try to scissor Marcelo, okay, looking for the mount position. Once again, Marcelo's holding the belt, bringing his knee up, he brings his knee up, right, and Junior's gonna open, escaping. So now Marcelo's gonna bend the leg, so he cannot scissor Marcelo anymore, so he's gonna start pushing, and still looking for the mount position. So you're here to teach, you know, the sweep called balloon, and when Marcelo is going to start, he's going to try to pass Junior's guard, he's standing up. Go ahead. So you see, the way he's standing up, that's exactly what a Junior wants. That's a big mistake when you try to get up without any base. So what a Junior is going to do here, he's going to just open the guard and take advantage from that, what Marcelo is offering him. So you see the way he's lying and he opens his legs, he's lying right, exactly, like that. Once again, he's lying his leg, exactly. So now what a junior is gonna do, he's gonna just slide his feet to Marcelo's waist, right there in the groin, so he can control Marcelo's balance. You see how Marcelo's, you know, pointing his head down. He has no balance here. Just because he was trying to get up, he's trying to pass the guard the wrong way. So now what Junior is going to do, holding behind Marcelo's elbow so he can control the top of the body, you know, with the head. So what Junior is going to do, he's going to start pulling his elbow. You see how he holds right here? So he can control the arms, you know, holding by the elbows right behind. So he's going to point Marcelo's head down and lift him a little bit. Don't try to hang with the guy. Just lift the point that you can just roll over with him. So what Junior is going to do, he's going to go with Marcelo to the mount position. Like I say, once you're here to show, you know, the balloon, the sweet balloon, but are you going to take that position, show you guys the mistake Marcelo is going to do trying to pass Junior's guard to stand up without any base. So he's got a good posture over here. So now he's going to strike past the guard, you know, right there once. That's what a Junior wants. You know, catch Marcelo without any balance. Like right now, Junior has his legs closed, you know, right Marcelo's back. So he's gonna open his slide, his legs down, right there, to the point he can put his feet in Marcelo's waist. You can see right here the way he's going. Right, he's just applying his feet right so he can control Marcelo's the low body. And holding behind the elbow, he's going to control the Marcelo's arm. So this way, you see, he controlled the four things, the four main points right here. So what he's going to do, he's going to use Marcelo's balance against him. I mean, he doesn't have any balance because, you know, the way his junior is holding, Marcelo is going forward. You see right here, the balance is no balance here. So what a junior is going to do, he's going to start lifting Marcelo a little bit. But I don't want you guys lift him and stand with him up. Like in your legs, I want you to just make sure then you use that to point his head down, make heavier his head, you know, head's got to be heavy a little bit. So he can follow him, go ahead, he can follow him to the mount position. Okay, you here to teach you the right way to choke from the guard position, you know, with the little details you guys didn't see before. So Junior is going to be in a guard position. Marcelo is inside the guard, and Junior is going to start working with his hand to pull the column. Go ahead, Junior. So that's the first step. You always got to do. You see, always when you talk about choking, you know, you got to make easy for you to get the first hand inside. So he's going to start pulling, and he's going to get the first hand. The main hand is the first one. So you see right here, he's ready, getting a grip over here with the thumb outside and the four fingers inside. So now to get the second hand, he's going to move a little bit on the side. You see how he's going to make easy for the arm to slide inside. That's the detail, you know, then you got to make easy for you. So now we see how the hand, it works like a knife, you get inside the neck. So once he grabbed the gi, he's going to come back, right facing Marcelo again. So now how are you gonna get the pressure from, you know, from your hands? Not only with the arms. I want you guys to understand, it's not only your arms, you're gonna be putting weight on the arms and pulling with the legs. So now look at the pressure. What that's one of the main thing in the whole thing is the way you're gonna squeeze the neck. You see right here the way he's grabbing the neck. So the same time that he's gonna start pulling Marcelo to him, he's gonna start moving the wrist inside. So he's gonna be blocking the air over here, blocking the oxygen. So once again, let me show you here. You see the way he's grabbing inside? Now he's touching with that part over here, the hand. Now he's gonna be squeezing. So he's gonna, you know, looking for put it less open, less space here. So now from here, what he's gonna do? He's gonna start pulling Marcelo. You know, don't open your elbows, you know. You gotta pull into your waist right here, real close. And after that, with the knees, he's gonna start pulling him to him. You see, the head of Junior is not touching the ground because he wanna use that as a weight in his hand to make heaven. Okay guys, you know, let's go again to the main points, how to choke from the guard position. You know, Junior's gonna choke Marcelo from the guard position, but you can see once I wanna make sure that you guys understand. You see the legs closed. You see right there, he are doing with the closed guard. Okay? So make sure then you when you do the choke, you know, you're doing the closed guard. Go ahead, Junior. Pulling his column to make ease the hand get inside. That's one of the main points, you know. So everything here, if you see the little detail, is gonna make it easy for you to understand. Just go step by step. The main hand, that's the first hand. That's the hand is gonna be choking him. It's gonna be, that's the powerful hand here. So he's gonna move a little bit to the side to make easy the arm get inside. Look at that. It's very easy for you when you move yourself a little bit. So you're giving something to get your hand inside. So right now you're gonna come back facing again. So he's gonna start pulling the elbows to the waist and pulling with the knees. Just make sure then you understand here, then the way you're grabbing, you know, once you grab over here, you're gonna start twisting your hands inside. That's very, very important. Then you see how he's doing, twisting your hand inside. So you get over here and you're gonna be twisting, pushing, pulling the same time. Once again, just make sure then you don't open your elbow. You're not doing this over here. No, gotta beat you, your waist right here, down, lower, okay? And the pulling with the legs, don't put your head on the ground. You wanna make that pressure over here heavy, you know, using your arms and your weight. Okay, guys, let's go see it once again, you know, faster to the little details, you know, the main points and how to choke from the guard position. Go ahead, Junior. Pull in the column, get your hand inside. Right away, get another hand inside. I just want to stop you guys to show you something of you. Sometimes what happens, you know, when the guy knows what, you know, Junior is doing, he tries to block his hand over here. So what I want you guys to do is a little detail, then you guys already saw that before from the mount position. Just switch your hand, pull him, Marcelo, to him, and get your thumb inside with the four fingers and bring over his head. I'm going to show you what, once again. From here, he tries to get the hand inside and he blocks, okay? So make sure then we keep your hand, the main hand inside, and what happens? He's gonna start pulling Marcelo with the knees forward, get the thumb to the other side, and you see how he's getting the thumb right behind Marcelo's neck. He's just gonna bring over, you see, moving his body. You see how he dislocates his body to the other side? Once again, for you guys to make sure that you guys understand, right here. Don't move yourself and bring your arm. You're gonna get stuck over here. You need to move to the other side with your arm and bring back. That's exactly when you're trying to get your arm inside. So from here, it's gonna be the same pressure with the knees and the elbow going down, pulling to him, and take your head out of the ground. Okay, guys, I want to start telling Danny, I don't want you guys to see that as a technique. I want you guys to see that as an exercise for you to know how you're going to move me. You're going to do the motion with your legs to defend your guard. You see right here, I don't want you that when you train with your partner, then he's going to be using any strength against you. There's an exercise for you to give you a good motion and good idea how to keep the distance. Don't let him pass the guard and get the side control, the 100 kilos, or get a better position on you. So what Marcelo is gonna do, he's gonna move him, you know, around Junior, and you're gonna see Junior using his legs, you know, to apply hooks, you know, in a spot then Junior can control the distance between Marcelo and him. You see right here, he keep one leg in the waist right there, so he can keep the distance, but at the same time, he has the hook over here in Marcelo's arms to make him come back. Don't let Marcelo go to the side. You see, the way he's applying is very simple. One right here goes to the arm. He's holding right behind the arm. And then the same time, he's going to put the waist over here. Switch a little bit, Junior. Put it right there. And he comes right here. There's a very simple way. You see, always you're going to be looking for hooks. How you call in jiu-jitsu, the ganchos. So you see right on the arm and the waist. Or you can switch. You can go lower. You can go with the hook inside. See how he's pulling one side and pushing the other side? So this way he's going to keep the distance and control Marcelo, so don't let Marcelo get on the side control. So let me show what happened when you don't have the good motion with your legs. When you don't know the distance, that's what's happening. When you see Marcelo right passing to the side and looking for a better position, you see right here, he's ready to get in the side control and going to the 100 kilos that you already saw before. Okay, guys, so once here to show you, how to practice the exercise and the guard position, how to defend your guard. I'm gonna show different details right now. And the main thing, for you to start doing the exercise, I want to show you the way you gotta do. Don't try to train any strength in your opponent. Just make easy. So switch positions when you already get the time to do that. I'm gonna show you. Always you start from the waist right here. You see the 2 foot right here in the waist, right there. He's applying right here. Okay, and you see how Junior's holding, right? He's not on the elbow or even close to the wrist, right between. So that means he can control the arm, you know. So you see, his point over here in that the exercise is to control Marcelo, to don't get under side control or get a better position. So look there, the first step, both, you know, he has his feet right in the groin, right in the waist right here. So from here, he's gonna switch, go ahead. Switch to the, you see, right, and from the elbow, right inside the arm, right inside the forearm, you see right here? He's going right in the bent part of the arm, right here. So he's keeping holding, and as soon as you can, you get your foot inside, you start pulling so you can stretch. So you see, he's gonna move the other ones, the same thing, right there. Looks like, you know, Marcelo can still go there, but if Marcelo moves to the side, Junior's gonna be following him. So you can see, come back 1 second, guys. So the next step will be the hooks low. So you see one, two to the arms, and three is gonna be low. Go ahead to the low, right there. And the other one too. Okay, so you see one here, so you put the hooks inside, you're gonna keep the sequence like that. You start from here, you start from here. Go ahead, Junior. One, two, move it, three, four. Go ahead, five and six. Once again, for you guys can see, start from the waist, one, two, three, four, and five. Keep the seconds so you're gonna get the motion, how to look for the best way to control the distance between you and your opponent, That's exercise, guys. Okay, guys, let's see a little bit, you know, how they're gonna show you, you know, working fast a little bit so you guys can see the motion. Go ahead. You see the hooks, you know, working with Marcelo tries to, that's what he's gonna try all the time, to get on the side. So to put the Carson's leg away, you know, Judo's legs away, so he can get in a side control under 100 kilos. You see the motion, he switch all the time, you know, even with the grabbing his arm with the hooks inside, the rotation inside. So he tries to apply his feet in a place, you know, he can block him to get in a side control. Keep going to the side over here, right there. You see the hooks on the arms, the hooks on the waist, right, and the hooks on the low, and the legs, right there. So he came on, Marcelo, that's gonna give you a hard time for Marcelo to pass on the side. Okay, you here to teach you, you know, the right way to get the American bar, Americana, from the guard. Junior's, Marcelo's inside Junior's guard. So I'm gonna go little by little, you know, step by step, so I can show you guys the little details. How are you looking for the arm? How are you gonna move your body to the side to bring Marcelo's arm to his back? So the first thing you gotta do, you gotta open your guard and look for it to make the hooks. You see the hooks right behind Marcelo. You can see right here. Junior's putting his foot right, hooking Marcelo, making the hook. So the second step will be when Junior's grabbing Marcelo's wrist with the four fingers and using, you know, it's a grip right here. For one, the thumb outside, and the four fingers, you know, going right over Marcelo's wrist. So the second step will be when Junior's gonna be looking for to get his second arm around Marcelo's arm, you know, the same arm he's grabbing, he's already grabbed it. So look over here. The way he's going is not getting over Marcelo's shoulder. He's going, moving himself to the side. So this way you're gonna avoid to the guy over here to block the shoulder, to block his arm, block his elbow. So he's going to the side and looking for, you see, he's like going to the side and going up a little bit so he can involve Marcelo's arms right here. So now he's gonna involve it. He's gonna involve Marcelo and hold, and you see right here, there's the one thing I want you guys to see. He's grabbing his own wrist right here. He's grabbing his own wrist right here. You see the way he's grabbing is with the four fingers outside, one thumb outside. He says, no, a shell hand, but, you know, with the four fingers right here. So now, the motion to bring Marcelo's arm to his back, you'll be when Junior's gonna start pointing his elbow, like you guys can see right here, his elbow's right here. Moving his elbow down, low, pointing to the ground. So he's gonna be moving Marcelo's arm to his back. And also, that's the main thing right in the whole position, so he cannot escape from you. Bring your leg over to his back. Right here, make a little hook. So he's gonna avoid Marcelo to flip over or pass to the side. So from there, when you have your safe position, you can start working with him, pulling Marcelo's arm to his back. You're here to teach you the right way to looking for the Americana, armbar from, you know, from the guard. So Marcelo's inside Junior's guard, and Junior's gonna be looking for Marcelo's arm to apply the armbar, the Americana, called American armbar. So the first thing you got to pay attention here is to looking for, every time you look to apply any technique, any submission, or any armbar, any full lock or anything, you got to look for to the safe point so you can keep that position before you go to the final. So right here, what a junior is going to do, he's going to look for to hook right behind Marcelo's foot, right here. You can see the hook. Just move a little bit, guys. Right here. You see the hook. That's Junior's leg coming right behind Marcelo's. Okay? Marcelo's leg. So the next step will be when Junior is going to be grabbing Marcelo's wrist. You see, it's a full grab. It's not a shell hand with the fingers together. It's like grab with the thumb outside. So make sure that Marcelo won't, he can take his hand away. The second step will be when Junior is going to be looking for to bring his second hand right around Marcelo's arm. So he's going, you see, that's one little detail over here. Don't try to go straight, okay, because he can block right here. Try to go to the side, and after he lift a little bit, so you give the space for you to get his arm. So you're right here, you see Junior's going to involve Marcelo's arm, and also he's going to be grabbing his own wrist with the same kind of grip, the same one, so Marcelo cannot escape from there. And the third step will be when Junior is going to start working with bringing Marcelo's arm to his back. So that's going to be the end of the position. But I want you to make sure that you understand, then you got to involve his arm over here. Make sure the same time you're going to bring his elbow, Junior is going to bring his elbow right, point down, bring his elbow over Marcelo's head. That leg over here, the same size you have Marcelo's arm, is going to come over to Marcelo's back. So that is going to make Marcelo stay in that position. He cannot escape from Junior. Like I'm going to show you guys right now, start going. You see, the leg comes with the hand together. So this way, what is he going to avoid? He's going to avoid Marcelo to do it. If he doesn't have the leg over here, he's going to make Marcelo go to the side or look for a better position. But now, what happened? When Junior has the leg right over Marcelo's back, that is going to avoid Marcelo to escape. And Junior is going to go to the end of the position, pulling his arm over to Marcelo's back. That's exactly what happened. You see, the two hands of Junior work together against one of Marcelo. Okay, guys, let's go just review the main points in the American armbar from, you know, the guard position. Go ahead, Junior. He's looking for the arm. He already grabbed the arm. He got the hook right behind Marcelo. So he's going to be looking for the arm. You know, make sure that you involve the arm. You don't try to go straight to the shoulder. He's going to pull him, right? Get the safety right in Marcelo's back, pulling his arm to the back. Make sure that you have the safety before you go to the end of the position.
Okay, now we're going to show you a technique to how we're going to sweep Junior, my brother, how my brother is going to sweep Junior from the guard position, okay? First, we're going to start off with a simple attack. When Junior put his hand out, right hand, he's putting down on the floor maybe to get some balance. My brother's going to take advantage of that move and go for the attack with the American armbar, okay? Right there, Junior, to avoid the armbar, he's going to try and hide the arm, stick the arm way in to block the attack, okay? Taking advantage of that, my brother's going to come with the left hand around, grab his belt, okay? Sit on the top of his lap, okay? Put that leg down, put that hand down on the same side to get some balance, and sweep him to the left. Ended up right in a mount position. Also, a better position for him, okay? From the guard, we try attack, a single attack to the armbar, and we ended up in a mount position. Okay, once again, my brother's gonna show you how we're gonna sweep Junior. My brother in a guard position, Junior inside of his guard, we're gonna show you how we're gonna sweep him coming from attack, American armbar, okay? So start off, Junior is gonna lay that hand on the floor, my brother's gonna go for the attack with the American armbar, okay? Junior is gonna hide that arm in there to try and avoid the attack, okay? So don't stop that motion. We're gonna drive the right hand right to the belt, okay? As you can see now, he's gonna lay the leg in there, sit right on the top of his lap, put that hand down in there to get some balance. Oh, see, you can see the motion right here, okay? To break, kind of breaking the balance. Now we're gonna drive him, push him with the right leg to the side, ended up right in a mount position. Okay, much better position coming from attack. Okay, now we're gonna show you a technique, how Junior is gonna sweep my brother I want you to understand one thing. When somebody's out of balance, don't matter his size, don't matter how big he is. You see my brother, big guy, Junior, okay, a guy and a smaller size, he also can sweep my brother in the same way. Don't matter. If he's out of balance, he can be swept. Okay? First, my brother is going to start off trying to pass his guard, okay, raising that knee. Boom. As soon as he do this, Junior is going to come with the arm, right arm, okay, the same side. He raised that knee. He's going to come and involve his leg, putting his hand right on the top of that knee, right here, like this, okay? Now, he's going to open the guard, okay? He'll open the guard, the lock right in the back, and he's going to position that leg right here, right on the waist. You see it? This way, he can also follow. He's getting close with the head by the leg, way here, the leg that my brother just raised it, okay? And very important to tell is all the time, we got to keep controlling that arm. It's very important because if you can see it, all the balance is here, okay? So we're going to control the arm all the time, okay? Now, Junior's going to raise that leg, pointing the heel down, also breaking balance. You see, little by little, we're breaking balance, okay? Little by little, he's going to go down, okay? Now, he's hugging that leg that my brother just raised it, okay? Now, as you can see, let's go over all the details. You see it right here, that hand, right after my brother raised that knee, okay? That heel pointing down to break the balance. The another leg wide and waist, okay, to give him more room. And 100% of a control of the arm, okay? Now we're gonna go for the whole sweep. He's gonna point that heel down and pull the arm at the same time, swinging with that leg and aiming that heel, to my brother's foot, okay? Doing the whole action at the same time. Go ahead, Junior. Okay, ended up right in the mount position, pretty easy. Okay, now we're gonna show you once again how Junior is gonna sweep my brother from the guard position, okay? My brother is gonna start off trying to pass his guard, raising that knee, okay? Right away, Junior come with the right hand, also the same side that my brother raised that knee is gonna be the hand that Junior is gonna come, involve the leg and position his hand right on the top of the knee, okay? The second important detail, right away he's gonna put that leg up right in the waist, okay, to also keep distance, okay? It's very important that we're gonna take the balance away from my brother and keep a distance at the same time, okay? Also, we want to control that arm, okay? We're gonna hold right here by the elbow, under the elbow, okay? And we're gonna control the arm 100% all the time, okay? Breaking the balance is gonna depend of that, okay? Controlling their arm, okay? Now, he's gonna bring that leg up, pointing the heel down, right by my brother's shoulder, okay? The another leg is gonna leave the waist. We're gonna swing that leg and pull the arm, okay? Throwing my brother right for the mount position, okay? We can do that now, look. Ended up right in the mount position.
Okay, you're here today to teach you the right way to get the armbar from the inside the guard. Marcel is gonna get Junior's arm and show you how to get the simple way to get the armbar. So let's go to the safe first so you can see how you're gonna keep that position, how you're gonna looking for to get the arm. So the first thing gonna happen, you know, Junior's gonna try to pass Marcelo guard. And right away, Marcelo is gonna put his foot, like you guys can see here, in the waist, right here. So that's gonna make Marcelo capable to move his, you know, his body to the sides. So the next step will be when Marcelo, go ahead, keep going. When Marcelo is gonna come with the second leg, with his right leg, and put it over Junior's back. What are the legs for? To make a pressure, to start locking Junior inside the legs, like you can see here. So the second one, you see, I want you guys pay attention right here, what happened inside. You see, Marcelo's got one hand, right in the collar, pulling Junior's down, and the other hand right behind elbow, you know, behind Junior's elbow. So what are these two hands doing right now? Just holding Junior inside the Marcelo's leg because their legs is open. If he doesn't have the safety over here, Junior's gonna escape. He's gonna put the legs down and pass the side control, and Marcelo doesn't want that. So it's very important that you keep the hand right inside, like you're gonna choke him, but you know, it's not exactly choking, but I want you, this is a holding position. And the second hand, hold the elbow. That hand is gonna be here to the end of the position when Marcelo is gonna pass the leg over Junior's head. So the next step will be when Marcelo is holding everything and he's gonna bring the leg over Junior's head and lock inside. So from here, you can see Marcelo is ready, he's gonna take his hand away from here and to put it right in Junior's arm, right here after he passed the leg over Junior's head. So you see, the whole thing is right over Junior's back to keep Junior real close to Marcelo. So the next step is gonna be when Marcelo is gonna lift his ribs up a little bit and stretch Junior's arm inside. That's the way you can see better. Okay, once again, let's review the main points in the whole position, how to get the arm bar inside the guard. So Junior is going to start passing Marcelo. He's going to try to pass his guard. And when he brings the knees up, Marcelo is going to right away put the foot over here to, you know, give the motion with the body. That's the foot four. So the right away, the hand comes to the neck and he keeps holding his elbow. Go ahead, keep going in the position. So right, the next step will be when Marcelo is going to come with the right leg and put it over Junior's back. So keeps Junior inside the legs. And right away, after you come in and make heavy right here, the other leg is going to pass over Junior's head. Right, from there, Marcelo is gonna take his hand away and hold Junior's arm right here, and the armbar is gonna be right there. Just gonna hip, he's gonna lift his ribs a little bit up so he can stretch the arm inside. Okay, you're here to show you, you know, the right way to get the triangle, the famous triangle inside the guard. I want you guys to pay attention, you know, where you're gonna bring the leg, where you're gonna pull the hand. That's the, if you know the little details, the main details, the position becomes so easy for you to understand and do it. So that's gonna be when Junior start passing Marcelo's guard. And that's what happened when the guys try to pass the guard and he got one hand outside and the other hand he keeps inside. So he probably, you know, it looks like he tried to separate the arms. So exactly, go ahead, Junior. So that makes like Marcelo bring his, you see the legs coming right over Junior's shoulder. So you see how he's hanging, that's a hook. There's the same hook you guys saw in the position before, and it makes heavy, you know, makes Junior go, keep Junior's inside the leg. Right away, with his foot right, like you can see right here, the foot right here in the waist, he's gonna make Marcelo be able to move without losing Junior from that position. So the next step will be when Marcelo start pulling the arm to the other outside to make tie. You see how Junior's getting the triangle. So the other point, as soon as he's very tight inside, the other leg is gonna come over Marcelo's foot, over his own foot, and point down. Make sure then when you close, don't keep the leg over the guy's back. You go right on the side, point your heel down. So the pressure is gonna come right in Junior's neck. Right away, when you release the arm over here, it comes right behind Junior's head with another hand. So the whole pressure is gonna point Junior's head down over his neck. See the pressure from the legs plus the arms. Okay, let's go again, reveal the main details, the little details, you know, the main positions, the main parts of the position right here. When Junior start passing Marcelo's guard, he brings his knee up, and right away he commits the mistake to get one hand inside and another hand outside. So that's exactly when he gives the chance for Marcelo to bring the leg over Junior's shoulder, so he can close over with his leg. But I want you guys to stop 1 second here, pay attention. It's very important that you hang your leg over his shoulder, his neck, you know, to make have over here, so he cannot escape from you. And it's very important that you hold the arm inside. You see, one arm is inside, the other one is outside. You can see. So now the next step is going to be when Marcelo still have his foot right in the waist of Junior, and he's going to be able to move. So it's going to make easy for him to meet the other leg over his foot. You see, the part he's going to bring his leg is going to be right here, the part inside. So he's going to close. Don't forget, don't put your leg over the guy's back, because if you know, it won't be any pressure. You gotta right bring on the side, point your heel down on the side. So right away after you lock everything, then you already know, then Junior cannot escape from here. And you see, the pressure comes from the legs with the arms. He's going to put his arms right in Junior's back. But I want you guys to see something over here. The pressure on the neck is like Junior, you know, he's squeezing his own neck with the Marcelo coming right after that, you know, over his arm and neck and make a lot of pressure, make it heavy. So he's going to drive Junior's arm to the side. Right away, the hand comes around after Junior and the back of Junior and his head, and he's going to point down. So we measure the pressure right here from the legs, the triangle, like you can see right here, plus the hands. That will be a lot of pressure.